As you know, presidential aspirant Bongbong Marcos did not attend his COMELEC hearing. His camp said he was very ill, and yet it's come out that he's actually had radio interviews before the hearing. What is your reaction, and how would you like the COMELEC to already act on this particular issue? You do know that the numbers of the former senator are more than 50% in the surveys right now. Should he be held in contempt already? Akbayan has been calling and asking the COMELEC to already hold Marcos in contempt.
Dapat walang exception. Dapat patas ang batas dito sa atin. And this is the problem we've had for so long, where we have a double standard of justice. I hope and I pray that the COMELEC will apply the law evenly, whoever is involved, even if it is a person who has 50% approval in the surveys. And I believe the COMELEC has just recently required the physician who issued the medical certificate to, I think, notarize the document and perhaps explain. We have to get to the bottom of this. We cannot let incidents like this, I think, just pass. Dapat may pananagutan kung may nakakasala.
Okay, now moving forward, is there a, of course, we all know about your personal history with the dictatorship, but is there a possibility for an attorney, Shell Diokno, if he wins as senator, to work with a Bongbong Marcos if he wins as president? Are you seeing that, Attorney Shell?
Well, I think the question is a bit different in the sense that if he were in the Senate as well as a senator, then you would need to work with other senators because you're in a collegial body.
Yeah. But the so you can work with Senator Aimee Marcos?
I have always been an issue-oriented person. To me, personalities are secondary to issues. And if an issue is there that I will push for, I really wouldn't care who is supporting, if other people are supporting that issue, who come from different colors as far as politics are concerned. But going back to your question, the Senate has always been independent of the executive branch, and it's been between the Senate and the lower house. The Senate has always shown its independence, and I would like to carry on that tradition. I think it's important for the separation of powers that is really fundamental in our government system, that be made into a reality. And I'm happy that even despite everything, we the Senate still has that tradition of being independent. I'd like to carry that on.
Uh-oh. You've already talked about the importance of the next president, even in terms of the ICC probe. You've already talked about that. But how existential is the next election? How existential is it for the Philippines, really? What would a Marcos presidency mean to you for the country?
Well, it will have a huge impact on the future of our young people, especially because we, as I've mentioned in so many different occasions, this coming election is not only going to be a choice of your political personality, it's going to be a choice of what kind of leader we want and we need to get us back on our feet, to get us into what they call a new normal. And that's really going to be the underlying decision of the electorate. It's not just going to be who has the nicest ads, but what kind of leader, who do we need to help us, help our economy, help our issues of unemployment, help our youth who are having a problem studying online, help our farmers and fisher folk who are already marginalized and getting even more marginalized given the situation. Mm-hmm. That, I hope, will be the defining issues in the coming elections.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And why should they vote for Shell Diokno?
I think my track record speaks for itself, and I will not be one to raise my own stool. I will be there for the people. I have been acting and serving the people as a private person ever since I became a lawyer more than 30 years ago. But I've realized that doing it, fighting for justice in the private sector has a lot of limitations. And because of the flaws in justice are so systemic, the only way to get justice for everyone, the only way to get the dejados, to make them llamado, is by fighting for justice and fixing the system within the Senate or within Congress.
All right. Attorney Shel Jokno, I hope to see you again soon, sir, and a happy new year to you.
Thank you so much, Karen. Thank you, and everyone. Thank you.